I've got Louis Strydom here, winemaker of Ernie Els Wines. I've done many wine dinners with him before. And I just want to say, Louis, welcome. And thanks for making the time. I know you're a busy guy. So thanks for making the time to come and visit us and to talk about Ernie Els Wines, and also for bringing some wine for us to taste.
Ruben, thanks a lot. It's great to be here. And it's great for us to show the wines that we make up on the Helderberg and at Ernie Els Wines.
Excellent. You know, I've always wondered about, you know, Ernie's involvement with wine and how it all started. How long have you been making wine for Ernie, for example?
I've been making wine, actually, Ernie, since 2000. So it's been 14 years now we've made Ernie Els Wines. It's funny how time really flies. But it's interesting how Ernie really got involved with wine. When, you know, when Ernie used to come and play tournaments down in Cape Town, always used to stay at Rissenfreda at the wine farm. And whenever after the day's tournament, he wished to come back to the farm and sit and sip wine on the relaxed and lovely, obviously, the ambiance of Rissenfreda. And Ernie's wife also grew up in Stellenbosch. So he got a real affinity for Stellenbosch and the winelands. And I was currently then the winemaker at Rissenfreda. And Ernie and John came to me back in 1999 and said, you know, they would really love to start a project together and start with a brand Ernie Els. And that is really how it was born back in 2000.
How involved is he still? I mean, I'm sure he still enjoys his own wine. How often does he still come to the farm? Are you in contact with him on a regular basis?
For Ernie, yeah, he only visits mostly in November, December, and he loves spending time on the farm. And I always say, Ernie is really difficult when he comes to the farm because all he wants to do is relax and enjoy the scenery, and we want to talk business, and everybody in the tasting room is so excited to have Ernie there. And I always say, like, pack all the merchandise away, because what he does, when guys are sitting drinking wine on front of the terrace, then the guy will say, come, sign the shirt for me. He said, no, go fetch a shirt of of the merchandise and come, I'll sign it. And that's how typically Ernie is. Always got time for anybody, and anybody that wants to have his signature or speak to him, he's always got time for him. And that's why, one of the reasons why Ernie's really loved on tour, because he has, doesn't matter who you are, he's got time for you.
Yeah. So you must be then quite a good golfer if you know, you've got a boss like Ernie Els. I'm sure you spend lots of time with him on the golf course.
I wish I did. You know, I always love telling the story that Ernie says, you know, if my handicap goes below 20, he's gonna get rid of me and I won't be working on the farm, because he knows I'm not spending enough time in the cellar. And because to be a good golfer, you need to spend time on the green boardroom, as they would say.
Tell us more about the activities on the farm.
Yes, we have lovely facilities on the farm. You know, we sit on the Helderberg, we're overlooking the whole of Stellenbosch. You see down into Falls Bay, Table Bay, the whole of the Helderberg lies behind you, the Simonsberg in front of you. And it's really, really lovely up there. And we do lunches, but it's not a full-on, I would say, like a real restaurant. We do steak and chips, or burger, or a chicken salad, cheese platters. So someone that wants to really just have a bite to eat quite quickly through the wineries, because he's traveling and he wants to move to the next wineries to taste. But what we do have, we have the trophy room on the farm. And in the trophy room, we have the British Open Trophy. We have the US Open Trophy there. We have many of Ernie's trophies that he's won all over the world, like the Loch Lomond, the Scottish Open Trophy. And one of the interesting trophies that are standing actually in the trophy room is when Ernie won the World Championships age 13 to 14 in San Diego in 1983. And that's what I always say when I say to people, actually, this trophy standing here, it's just, and that was just natural raw talent. And that's what Ernie's always had, is that natural raw talent to play golf. And that is what we have in the cellar, that trophy room. And then we have a lovely barrel cellar where people can see actually where we spend our time. And we have about 500 barrels in the barrel cellar. And where we actually, from Ernie Els's commitment towards wine. Because sometimes people like to say, how serious is Ernie about wine? And is it just a celebrity wine? For me, it's very much real, because I work with it every day. But somebody out there, how serious is Ernie and the wine that we make? You know, we've been making wine, like I said, for 14 years now. And I always say, people maybe would buy the first bottle of Ernie Els because of the name Ernie Els, but you won't buy the second bottle if it's not a quality wine. And we've been in business, and our business has been growing really well over the last, especially the last 3 years. For me, that is just an indication of the quality of Helderberg, the terroir, and the quality of wine we make on the farm. And I think we're starting to move past the name Ernie Els, because that is, for me, a bit of a competition. I have to compete against my own brand name because of who Ernie is. But I think it's the quality that we make consistently now, year in and year out, that is really starting to show through in the bottle.
So the aging potential is good as well. I mean, but what would be the oldest Cabernet that you have at the moment?
Yeah, so for us, it's the 2000, the maiden vintage. It's 2000, so it's 14 years now.
14 years.
And that wine is still showing beautifully. It's lovely, still together. Those tannins are there. Tannins are natural preservative. People don't realize that. It's there. If you have a little bit more of a grippiness, a little bit of a dryness, that's actually there to protect the wine over, you can say, over a 10 to 15 year period. If I can take away all those tannins and make the wine easy drinkable, but that's not the goal of our premium wines. We have other wines in the range which are a little bit more accessible, a little bit more drinkable. So you're going to understand, if you're dining out in the evening, understand what you want to achieve with the wine that you have in your glass and what you want to pair it with, specifically with food.
So Louis, talking about pairing, we let you know what we'll be cooking today. What did you bring along for us to taste?
Two really interesting wines from the farm. You know, the first one is the Cabernet Sauvignon, rich and powerful. The second one is a Shiraz-based blend with a little bit of Cab and Mourvèdre and Grenache. A little bit more softer and a little bit more approachable. So it'll be really interesting how it pairs with the dish.
Lovely.